What's up, Flow fans? We're back. And in this video, we're gonna show you how to build a flow that checks Twitter every day to see how people are speaking about your product or brand. We'll then show you how to use the flow bot in Teams to kick this flow off on demand, just in case you want a spot pulse check of your sentiment, right? So Melissa, would you show us how you built this one?
Of course. All right, so I'm gonna jump in. Here I'm at flow.microsoft.com. And I've already built this flow, but if you're gonna create a new one, you would click on create from blank. So now you can see I have a recurrence trigger. So to use the flow bot in Teams, you have to use the recurrence trigger. So I have an interval of 1 day. So that means that this will run every day without the flow bot in Teams, but it will also run on demand. I'm gonna add the action to search tweets. Here I've put the flu so we can get a good example of negative sentiment. No one likes the flu. So I did hashtag there and it's gonna search the text through all tweets. And if I show the advanced options, I'm gonna limit the results because there's probably quite a few tweets out there in the world that don't like the flu. All right. So when I add a detect sentiment step, that's using text analytics to read through and see if it has negative sentiment or not. So in the text, you can choose to add dynamic content, and you can choose the tweet text. You can see right there. Then you would add a condition. Because you only want to see the negative sentiment score. So I've chosen score from the dynamic content, and my qualifier is going to be less than 0.5. So the scores in text analytics, 0 is very bad, and 1 is very good. So if I do less than 0.5, that means it's anything less than average. Now, if the score is not 0.5 or below, I don't want anything to happen. So I'm going to leave this if no blank. And if yes, I want to create a table so that it'll look nice in my email to show me all of my negative tweets. So I'm creating a table from the tweet body, and I'm saying yes to include headers and leaving columns as automatic. Next, I need to email that HTML table. So I've added an email action. You'll see my email there in the to line, a email subject, negative tweet report, and now I've selected from dynamic content the output. One very important thing, in the advanced options, you need is HTML to say yes, or this is not gonna look very nice when you get it in your email. All right, so that's the final step. Now, let's go ahead and run this flow using the Teams flow bot. All right, here I am back in the flow bot. You can see that number 4, send negative tweets that are retweeted in a report, is the one that I need to run. So I'm gonna type in run flow 4, hit enter. And now it's gonna run that flow for me on demand. I'm gonna go into my email. Negative tweet report, very quick. So now we've got all these details about the tweet, but the tweet text is where we're gonna see, you know, the flu, worst feeling I've ever had. You know, negative sentiment. There's gonna be 20 of them since we've limited it to 20. So, you know, it gives you a quick look and it shows you need to pay attention to some things that are out on Twitter and maybe respond and get back with the person who tweeted this or find out why. And that's all I needed to show you today. So we have gone ahead and showed how to build a flow that will send a report of all of your negative tweets using the Flow bot in Teams. And thank you for joining us.